Hi and welcome to my first video on this topic of genes and how they affect you. This first video will be looking at the structure of DNA and how it's organised within your cells. Okay, so the first thing to establish is what makes you unique or what makes you you. And so the two things that determine individuals' characteristics are the environment and their genes. Your genes are received from your parents, and so therefore they are inherited. And the environment is essentially all of the stimulus that you receive from outside. So it can be things like your exposure to light, can be the amount of food that you're exposed to, and your experiences in general. Okay, so your genes basically are a blueprint. They enable you to make things called proteins. And so proteins are the building blocks for life. They're the structures that you're made of, and they're the chemicals that control the reactions in your body. And so your genes, like I said before, are a set of instructions for making these proteins. So the smallest subunit of genetic material is called DNA, and this diagram here represents the DNA found within your cells. Now, if we take one of these sections here, pieces of DNA here, then there are 3 billion of those inside virtually every cell within the human body. And these are what's known as a base. And so these bases come in four different varieties: adenine, thymine, guanine, and cytosine, mentioned at the top here. And you'll notice they always pair together in a very, very specific way. The way in which they always go together is the adenine always binds to the thymine, and the cysteine always binds to the guanine regardless, and you can see that represented here with these different coloured bases. So for instance here, the guanine's in green and the cytosine is in red, and you'll notice that those two always bind together, and the thymine in yellow and the adenine in blue, they always bind together. So with DNA, you not only have the bases in the middle, but you also have two other sections that are represented by this grey strip here, and that's a phosphate group and a ribo sugar joined together. So the three major parts of DNA are a ribosugar, a phosphate group, and the bases that you have here. Now, you may have heard of DNA being referred to as a double helix, and all that simply means it means that it has two strands that are connected together that twist around one another, a bit like a cord spring, and hence the name double helix. Okay, so this diagram here has 9 nucleotide bases joined up. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now, the next major subunit of genetic material is called a gene. And a gene is something which codes for a particular characteristic, be that eye colour or hair colour. And a gene usually consists of tens of thousands of nucleotide bases and pieces of DNA joined together. So you start to get an idea of just how small a piece of DNA actually is. Okay, so in summary, your DNA, which is the smallest subunit of genetic material, is referred to as deoxyribonucleic acid, or DNA for short. It's made up of nucleotide bases, of which there are 4, adenine, thymine, cysteine and guanine, a ribosugar and a phosphate group. The bases, they always pair up in a particular way, so the adenine always binds to the thymine and the cysteine always binds with the guanine, and they form this structure called a double helix, which basically looks like a coiled spring wrapped around. A gene which codes for a particular characteristic, this can be something like eye colour or hair colour, and a gene is made up of loads of pieces of DNA, in some cases up to tens of thousands of pieces of DNA.